next piece would be Cow of Drum, arranged by John Higgins. Our next piece would be the Nutcracker Suite by Tchaikovsky, arranged by Paul Lavender.
Thank you. Before we go to the second phase of our Christmas gala, I would certainly like to thank all of you for coming out to see this portion. I hope you stay for the remainder. We have a dance and drama and then our university choir.
Our last and final piece is The Glory of Christmas, arranged by Paul Jennings, orchestrated by Teresa Jennings.
Thank you. Dear editor, I am 8 years old. Some of my little friends say that there is no Santa Claus. Papa says if you see it in the sun, then it's so. Please tell me the truth. Is there a Santa Claus? Signed, Virginia O'Hanlon. The editor responded to Virginia by writing the following piece. Virginia, your little friends are wrong. They have been affected by the skepticism of a skeptical age. They do not believe except they see. They think that nothing which is not comprehensible by their little minds, all minds, Virginia, are small. In this great universe of ours, man is but a mere insect. In his intellect, as compared with the boundless world around him, he is measured by the intelligence capable of grasping the whole of truth and knowledge. Yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus. He exists as certainly as love and generosity and devotion exists. And you know that they are abound and they give you joy and life to its highest beauty. Alas, how dreary would life be if there were no Santa Claus? It would be as dreary as if there were no Virginias. There would be no childlike faith, no poetry, no romance. We would not have enjoyment except in sense and sight. The light within, the light with which childhood fills the world would be extinguished. Not believe in Santa Claus? You might as well not believe in fairies. You might get your papa to hire men to watch all the chimneys on Christmas Eve and catch Santa Claus. But even if they did not see Santa Claus, does that mean it is not so? Nobody sees Santa Claus, but that is no sign that there is not one. The most real things in this world are those that neither children nor men can see. Did you ever see fairies dancing on the lawn? Of course not, but that's no proof that there is no Santa Claus. Nobody can conceive or imagine all the wonders there are unseen and unseeable in the world. You tear apart the baby's rattle and see what makes the noise inside, but there is a veil covering the unseen world, which not the strongest man, nor even the united strength of all the strongest men that ever lived could tear apart. Only faith, fancy, poetry, love, and romance can push aside that curtain and view and picture the supernal beauty and glory beyond. Is it all real? Ah, Virginia, in this world there's nothing else more real and abiding. No Santa Claus? Thank God he lives, and he lives forever. 1,000 years from now, 10,000 years from now, he will continue to make glad the heart of childhood.
Think of a place.
paraphrased from a Christmas sermon on peace delivered by Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. on Christmas Eve, 1967, at Ebenezer Baptist Church in Atlanta, Georgia. This was the last Christmas that Dr. King was here on this earth. If there is to be peace on earth and goodwill toward men, we must finally believe in the ultimate morality of the universe and believe that all reality hinges on moral foundations. Something must remind us of this as we stand once again in the Christmas season and think of the Easter season simultaneously, for the two somehow go together. Christ came to show us the way, for men love darkness rather than light, and they crucified him. And there on Good Friday on the cross, it was still dark. But then Easter came. And Easter is an eternal reminder of the fact that truth crushed to earth will rise again. In 1963, on a sweltering August afternoon, we stood in Washington, D.C., and talked to the nation about many things. Toward the end of that afternoon, I tried to talk to the nation about a dream I had had. And I must confess to you today that not long after talking about that dream, I started seeing it turn into a nightmare. Yes, I am personally the victim of deferred dreams, of blasted hopes. But in spite of that, I still have a dream, because one cannot give up in life. If a person loses hope, somehow he loses that vitality that keeps life moving. He loses that courage to be, that quality that helps an individual to go on in spite of all. So today, I still have a dream. I have a dream that one day justice will roll down like water and righteousness like a mighty stream. I dream that in all our state houses and city halls, men will be elected who will go there to do justice and have mercy and walk humbly with their God. I dream that one day war will come to an end, that men will beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. That nations will no longer rise up against nations, neither will they study war anymore. Yes, I have a dream today that one day the lamb and the lion will lie down together, that every man shall sit down under his own vine and fig tree, and none shall be afraid. I still have a dream today that one day every valley shall be exalted and every mountain and hill will be made low. The rough places will be made smooth and the crooked places will be made straight. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed and all flesh shall see it together. With this faith, we will be able to speed up the day when there will be peace on earth and goodwill toward men. It will be a glorious day. The morning stars will sing together and the sons of God will shout for joy.